What kind of trees are those?
Right on, right on, right on, right on.
You're not there. Every time we come to Mississippi, I always go all over and see your people stuff. We go to my city, you get all grumpy.
Now, wait just a minute. We went to your
one
hometown.
One time.
Well, shit.
And you left me on the highway. Drove all. Ron, didn't he? Oh, that's what I said. Left me.
We went in another car.
No, we didn't want in the car.
Oh, I'll tell you what.
I
tell you what.
I want you to go with me sometime, like I go
okay,
with you.
Okay. I'll tell you what.
I don't want to go this time.
No, you got it.
No, I want to go when I want to go. Same way you do.
No, you got it.
Don't let me force.
No, we'll
Then you push halfway in, let it stay halfway in until the thing gets the norm, the heating thing gets the norm. And then you push it all the way out.
Try to get them?
My mother feeds me fish sometimes. These things, the same thing, I can be easy to draw like that. Who likes bread?
Mm-hmm.
Me?
Me would like
lot of butter on it.
I like
hot, a lot of butter in
it. Yeah, I like a real lot of butter. You like that?
So that's some sandwich.
There's a big eater around here. You're doing it right. And I read in this book where it says, Michael Felicia in my way. Said, you know, say people that have heart attacks, usually comes from your diet.
Uh-huh.
And usually people say, usually people eat the same things their parents ate, their forefathers. So if you change your diet, a lot of baldness and stuff like that you won't even have because it's only through diet.
Mm-hmm. I never knew how to cook before we got married.
Well, I would have time to experiment, I guess, like if I have, you know, the studio and all. I think I'd probably be really out of sight cooking on with some other things.
Uh-huh.
The one dish things. Like, one thing I sure would like to cook is that tuna casserole.
Uh-huh.
But I don't know how.
Oh, that's really easy.
Oh, you know how?
Yeah.
Well, I just found out that seasonings is the most important thing. All these little stuff in these jars and things. Like, one time I was at the studio.
Uh-huh.
And, I had nothing that I had to cook with scraps.
Mm-hmm.
And it was so good. And I used everything from jars mostly, you know? And it was just seasoned like to the, I mean, to the taste. God, it was so good. But I remember one mistake I made. I had dinner and I always try to do it up where you just have just a liver, like spaghetti or something, you know?
Uh-huh.
It's always like, okay, like, you know, giving a dinner. If you don't know what you're doing, you know,
uh-huh.
you don't cook the other way, you know that it'll always go.
Telephone, Craig.
Who is it?
Craig, telephone. Craig Gaines. This is your eye.
Oh,
I'm sure deep as liver, I think so.
Where I'm looking, I can't find anything. Not even on the chase lounge. And it's nowhere on the chase lounge.
You found it?
Listen at the sound. I paid $100 for this big ass pillow. I wish I could get it cut down.
That's why it costs $100. It's big.
She's honest.
Is that son? Are those your trophies?
Yeah.
And that ain't yours.
Well, Ronnie's, you're in the
way. Where's my trophy? Where's my trophy at? Where's my trophy?
That's a water boy trophy, it's not. Now you make yourself at home. I'm in and out. Back is like from the back.
Remember Central Park when you did that TV special? We did a tape of that too.
I don't like that.
Mother?
Listen, Tina, you made the greatest exit I've ever seen on that one.
Doing that?
No, it was like you were flying off the stage.
Really?
Uh-huh, with your arms going like this.
Where?
At Central Park.
You never see it, brother. You sleep.
What happened?
It was like what I was doing with my arms.
Yeah.
It looked like I was flying.
Really?
Here they are. Ike and Tina Turner. Ike and Tina Turner, I forgot to mention, you're going to Japan for 2 weeks to perform at the, how do you pronounce it, Mugan Nightclub?
Yeah.
Mugan Nightclub, June 20th. You played Japan before, though, right?
Yeah.
Is it, most people who go over there, entertainers, especially musicians, come back and say it's a real gas because they're familiar with the records and they collect them, and they're great collectors over there of American songs and jazz and so forth. Well, what is it like? Do you find it different?
I was worried at first because I was thinking, well, they don't know what I'm saying and all this while screaming and dancing, you know, what are they going to think? And it really went over great, you know.
That's universal. They know what you're doing there. They know what you're doing. Do you find any of the Japanese cities different, or are they basically the
No, but you know same? One thing that really fascinated me? The first thing I do when I get up in the morning is open the curtains and all, and I look down, and all these little people, well, the older generation is shorter than the younger generation. And they all sort of walk on the same side of the street, even downtown. Say, for instance, like, all the people that are going, they're going the same side of the street, and the people that are coming on the same set, so you don't have that hassle of sort of bumping into each other.
That makes sense.
Yeah, and all downtown it was like that, even not just, you know, the places where they work and everything. Right. And they were all, they looked like little hamsters, I was up so high, and they were sort of migrating out of this tunnel, you know, and going in.
You want to hold it down, Ike?
Maybe you can set something up on the back of that.
No, it's all right. I'm going to give you that. That's all right, Blue. Blue, it's okay. That's okay, because I just blew the... That's our food. One for you, one for me. You know that stand that I got for that bass, the piano bass? You know what?
Yeah.
A long time ago, years ago, when I had trouble out of bass players, I got the piano bass.
No, that
Like, I was thinking maybe that mug will sit on that stand. I can use that stand if you know where it's at.
Okay.
Like, that's the fourth piano I put in this place. So finally I got the piano that's got the sound that I want. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
In this world, you got people crying because they're happy. Right. You got people crying because they're sad. You got people crying because they're in pain. You got people crying for sad reasons, old people that didn't have homes with them. Right. So you said if you had the nickel and the dimes for the eyes of the world, for the crying eyes of the world, mm-hmm. The eyes is crying something because the crying eyes because they shit. If I had the nickels and if I had the dimes, of the eyes of this world, the eyes that can't see for crying, the eyes of the cold, something, I don't know what the next one is, the crying eyes of the cold, of the old. I'm trying to tell you basically that it's the crying eyes, it's the people that's crying because they're happy, so people see people in love and they go, oh, you know, and then you got the people that's crying because they're hurting in pain.
Everybody's crying.
Yeah. But everybody is crying, even of all, but I'm trying to tell you of all things, but I'm trying, the last one, I want to be like, based on something love, because everybody want to hear about something about their love. And then the loved one is because the lover has left him. What would I do? And if the ride comes in, somebody help, and the group is back, help. And then I go into my story about something, I don't know. But it's I got to narrow it down where it makes sense. But this seems like it should make sense.
To me, it does, because
if I have the nickels and if I have the dimes, of the eyes of the world, the eyes that can't see but crying. There it is right there. But I like to say things in my song. I just don't like to write songs. They're not saying nothing. I want to say something. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, just what I just said then, it says a lot. Because who ever thought of, like, the eyes in the world? Like, people walk around blind. And other people walk around can see, but their eyes are full of tears.
Poetry.
Yeah, right. I guess so.
Oh, really?
Anyway. But I got to get more into reality about the crying eyes of the different people. I want to make it more into reality so you can see a picture of happy people crying, sad people crying, people in pain. I don't want to dwell on pain in the army because that's been done too much. But I want to dwell on pain and tears, love and tears, happiness and tears. Aha!
Happiness and tears.
Love and tears. Pain and tears.
Hand full of gimme, mouth full of much obliged.
Much obliged.
Much obliged.
Right on. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Hand full of gimme.
Do it.
Do it. 2, 3, 4.
Hand full of gimme.
I feel it, like, cause the way they're doing it, slowing it. That's how the bus in. Take a child plane. Is this a commercial airline?
Huh?
It's a commercial airline.
Huh?
This is a commercial airline.
Come on, Doug.
Well, I'll tell you what, I ain't checking mine.
Three letters that have been with us for a long time. I call them three.
doing it right.
Do it right.
What you mean, do it right? Shake a tail.
Oh, why don't you bend over and shake your own tail feather?
Well, why don't you bend over and shake your... Listen here, you dirty rat. Why don't you shake your own tail feather?
Now, there was a day that we used to do. You know what they're going to dance. Good God Almighty, they hold it to Peter. We may not do this thing.
Out there, he gets what he wants, but later on, don't want what he got. So then he comes home to his respect and understand it. But then when he gets home, his old lady's already heard about it. One of the things she says to him is, I heard about you today, about last night, and night before last, with your other woman. But he had the nerve to ask you, which one? Yeah. Wants to know who told you. Well, now listen, you can tell him. Tell him you heard. Well, you tell him. Tell him! Fellas, today things have changed. Us girls have come a long way. It's called soul music with the Greeks. Because ain't nothing no good without the Greeks.
Right on.
Yes. Childhood, the mother and father not getting along,
yeah.
Separating, and I went through that whole thing. So, and then they have like sort of,
I had most of that money
some kind of like an unhappy marriage and that sort of thing. So I keep thinking that I really like for happiness.
Do you remember when your mother was growing up? 30 was like really like considered old for a woman.
Uh-huh.
She was like.
Yeah.
A woman then, really.
Right.
And like today, a woman in her 50s and 40s is still considered a young woman.
Uh-huh.
Still looks great.
Right.
And like for instance, like when I get in my 50s, I'm still not going to be considered an old woman. My star that chart says that later in life, things get better for me.
Thank you.
Sherman.
I don't believe I ate the whole thing. I don't believe I ate
Jesus,
the whole thing.
No, Ralph. I ate it.
That's the way it is, folks, at What's Your Beef restaurant in Canoes Plaza. Dine evenings at What's Your Beef and enjoy the his and hers prime rib dinner. His, a regular man-sized, delicious, and tender prime rib. Hers, a petite succulent cut, each with a big flaky baked potato and a satisfying tossed salad. All this for only $7.50.
This song is from one of our albums that says, what you hear is what you get.
And what you feel better yet.
And the song says,
Oh, baby. Ooh, shit, baby.
say,
Now wait a minute, baby. I ain't never tried to do nothing like this ever before. But I'll try anything one time.
Thank you. Thank you.
albums. People always ask him what he's talking about.
I know it.
I still say to Tina, and they're talking to their ears.
I just think some people who speak clearly when they want to go. What they say?
He. So what? I feel a lot better. I got 20 more examples. I feel a lot more
better. That's my girl out of town, you both? With the driver with the kitties?
No, that's all right. Stay in.
It's all right. She's doing
good. Can I get a picture with you with her?
Sure.
For our kids?
Yeah, sure.
Come on. Get in there. I hope this works. We can throw over this thing.
I'll do
one.
I bet.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah. He put his thing on the book.
Yeah, hold that one.
Okay. One more, just in case. Beautiful. Thank you very much.
Okay.
They're fussing at you about your talking.
Yeah.
You do the same thing to me about it.
Yeah, I know. I see
you. I'm
humble.
See, I know what you say just then. See, I know, and that's all I heard.
That's all he said.
No, he didn't. What he said
for?
Yeah, I know. You said what?
Yeah, I can understand.
No, not that.
I didn't say
much
word.
Oh, you didn't know what you said. That's why I was
doing
Wayne.
No fretting.
Look
hall.
What I did to Jackie.
Wayne.
I hit him in his mug.
The way we've been working is because of the just of our show being as exciting as it is, and we couldn't rely on records, so therefore we had to keep the show strengthened to play for all the different audience, the different audience, many different audience as we have been playing for. And if you do that, in order to do that, say you're, it's all right, just there. Yeah. In order to do that, you're you have to stay with today's trend in dressing, today's trend in music.
I know looking at a picture of you like years ago.
Yeah, it's like incredible. That's right. It's like you look at a lot of people now, and they're doing the same thing in makeup. They're doing the same thing in wigs, you know, and the same thing in clothes, and you just can't do it. You got to go with the world. And that's how we've maintained it, you know. Yeah, I'm home a lot now. As a matter of fact, I'm home all week, Monday through Thursday, Friday, Saturdays, and Sundays.
Oh, good. We can go to lunch someday.
Right. And really, it doesn't affect me, except for, like, the days that I get my appointments mixed up an hour late.
I won't even go into that Saturday, Tina. I mean, you know,
But other than that, you know, I'm an active person, so I'm always running to the laundry, the cleaners, the seamstress, so, like, whenever I have an appointment, it doesn't really bug me. I it's just a part of it all, of the entertainment, you know, so I just take it that way. It doesn't really upset me or anything. I'm recording when I cut the tracks, when I write the lyric, and I go in and knock it out just like that, but that's usually at night.
It looks great. You look like a queen.
Oh, really? I'll stay up here.
Really good.
Well, you know, I don't understand what kind of a writer I am. Some had individually tell me. I get sort of tired of writing about the man and the woman unless it's something really different, really strong. So I just don't want to write anything. I love you, dead, or out of yours, yeah, you know. So I just try to write like anything, the plaque on the wall, the twiddling flower, or anything that's, you know, like sex is the thing today. So I try to write about like a little bit about like hitting wise that sex, you know, just anything, just sort of the hip. I find that in my writing, I want to be really like with the hip thing, because everybody's like, I'm sort of hip bag.
Yeah.
But I find that a lot of it I'm not able to use. Like one song I wrote, Kay got laid, Joe got paid. But, well, you know, a long time ago, laid was when you got drunk, you know? So then it's really a groovy song. And Ike's as well. Only thing he could do was like go to the FCC and get the definition of laid and so forth. But then he says, to keep that. Well, he's gonna fight it. Because like, it's really a clean song. Really like, just like a typical prostitute today, really like, you know. But it's clean song, really nice groove and everything. But I find myself writing that way, and it must be the other me or something, you know, because I don't know. But it's just really weird. And that next album coming out, I wrote all the tunes.
Every one of them?
The tunes, since Nuff Said, I wrote them all about everything.
It's a documentary.
And it's, I've gotten used to it. I've never been aware of where she's there anymore. She's been doing it for a quick while now, so the camera's always on. And I'm not one of those to stay posed on the camera, so I just go, you know? And then I look back, I go, wow, look at myself. And occasionally, she comes up and she can hook the thing up to a television, and you can see what she's got on it, you know? And listen, so amazing. I look so huge on that thing. Everybody else looks about their size. I am actually like an Amazon. I hate to talk about it because it's strange that nothing's happened to me. If I discuss them, something always happens. Whether she gets sick or whether she has to go home. So I remember one day I said, I lifted my finger just the other day, this fingernail here. These two had held over, but these three had broken. Now they're back, right? I said to myself, amazing how this fingernail stay. And I turned up to Miz. I said, Miz, help me get out this bracelet. So with this bracelet, it's hard to open. And as I was doing this, I did and broke the nail.
Oh,
and it happens with me every time. Every time I say, so-and-so hasn't been here. Boom.
Yeah.
There they are. It never fails with me. So I don't discuss things that I don't want to have.
I know.
People that understand. I'm sure.
Too busy looking at Ike.
Well, that's one of my problems.
Nobody never looks at Ike. I'll bet you know Ike's hair. Dada, Ike's hair's not together.
You be looking at Ike?
It's time for you to go.
Obviously.
I think I want my other ring. stop. I'm coming.
She's known as the hardest working little lady in show business today. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a great big round of applause for Miss Tina Turner?
Together.